Hey Carnage House people, it's Dougal here checking in. Alex and I are on the way to the ferry stop right now. We're going to the free Julian Assange rally? Get him out of the damn Ecuadorian embassy. Alex, why don't you come join me around here and tell us why we're going to the Julian Assange rally?
We think that Julian Assange performs a pretty fundamental role in society, and he is pretty much one of the last journalists that is not succumbed to the powers and the tentacles of the deep state. He's one of the only journalists who's actually out there doing its job. He's not a member of the establishment, he's for the people, and his basic argument is, well, if the data's not safe with the government, then pretty much every other government and every other spy agency's got it, so why don't we just give it to the people anyway? And I like that. It's power to the people, knowledge is power, power moves only here on Carnage House.
Power moves.
Yep.
Thank you.
What you get?
I'm going to get a ham and cheese croissant and a cookie.
We're here, yeah, this is the background at the Free Julian rally. It's just starting off. I think they're selling t-shirts behind us. Good look at picking one up.
I think we might get some hot stuff, some fresh new merch.
To wear on the podcast.
We're going to wear it. Looks like a mixed turnout. Probably not the biggest we've ever seen, but still people here, so that's good. Deep State's trying to keep it well policed. There's actually quite a strong police presence here. Might see if we can uncover some dirty dealings.
Roscoe's here making his first appearance on social media in a long time. Special Julian Assange event.
Gotta come out for Julian.
Gotta come out for Julian. Gotta get Julian out.
Gotta get him out.
Privilege in recent weeks to speak with many people, but they include Christine Assange. In a tweet she sent this morning, which she asked me to read to you, she notes, "Julian has not seen sunshine or felt rain for 6 years. His eyesight is fading. His teeth are causing great pain. He is suffering from edema. His legs are swelling. His bone density is reducing severely because he has not been in the sunshine for 6 years. That is the torture that is being inflicted on a publisher and journalist.
Traditional media can be bypassed. WikiLeaks deals in the raw material that, when revealed, governments hang themselves with. That's why they want Assange's head. They lust for revenge, as the professor mentioned, and to stop further leaks that threaten their grip on power. That the corporate media has turned on Assange and WikiLeaks reveals their service to the state and how much they prioritize their style of life, disregarding the carnage they help bring about.
The refusal by the Department of Foreign Affairs to acknowledge, let alone enable, the United Nations declaration that Julian is the victim of arbitrary detention and has a right to his freedom is a scandalous breach of the spirit of international law.
Over the coming months, the IYSSE will do everything it can to take forward this crucial fight to build the mass movement that will secure Julian Assange's freedom. Thank you very much.
My name's James Cogan, I'm the National Secretary of the Socialist Equality Party. Obviously we called today's rally as part of a fight to develop momentum, to develop a movement among the working class, among young people in Australia, to demand the action by the Australian government to secure his freedom from his arbitrary detention inside the Ecuadorian embassy in London. The reality is that since the persecution of Assange began in 2010, the Australian government, under both Labor and the Coalition, have done nothing to defend Assange. They have completely violated their responsibilities to the rights of an Australian citizen and the rights of a journalist. It has to end, and the rally was to make a very clear appeal for the mobilisation of the force that can secure Assange's freedom, that is, the great strength of the working class.
Australians, what do you think is about the right number who should die in a revolution?
How many people died now? How many people are already dying under capitalism? You know? Do you think we live in peaceful times? Do you live in peaceful times? What I urge you to do is make a donation to help us. It's not a charity. It's building socialism. Okay?
I'm going to pass, but I appreciate. I respect your levels of engagement. Right? Your levels of engagement. Right?
Joe, have you got a message to the young Australians who are either unaware or unmotivated regarding the Julian Assange issue?
Yes, I do. I think they need to get themselves aware and educated about who Julian Assange is. Why? Because he is, as I said in my address today, he's doing the job that mainstream journalists are no longer doing for the most part, which is to hold government account. And an election is one thing, and after officials go into power, they seem to do whatever they want. Mm-hmm. And wait till the next election and then make more promises. So journalism has to keep the officials accountable by challenging their statements and their actions. And that affects all people, including young people. It's not just an issue for your parents or your grandparents or older people who seem to have the power in society. We're all affected by decisions of government. And particularly young people, if they serve in the military, Australia has this propensity of following the United States, a very aggressive power. You have to know why a government is doing what it's doing, and to be able to challenge that, and that is where the role of journalism comes in. And WikiLeaks has published documents from governments that the governments don't want you to know about. They're holding secrets, and you should know what those secrets are. You should be curious about what those secrets are. And I will say this, your personal lives and your school and your friends, and this is obviously of critical importance to you, maybe most importance, but you have to look beyond your own lives to the larger society. There are people all over this country and other countries that are suffering because of decisions the government make that are made in secrecy, and WikiLeaks reveals those secrets, and that's why you have to support WikiLeaks and Assange, who's being held in the embassy in London of Ecuador against his will, basically, because if he steps outside, he's arrested, sent to the United States, and very well will be convicted and spend the rest of his life in prison simply for publishing those secrets.
Do you have anything to say about Consortium, WikiLeaks, and the role of alternative media?
Yeah, it's crucially important, alternative media, because as I outlined, as everyone seems who in this area right now at this rally knows, corporate media is beholden to government, and it shouldn't be. People in private corporate media like to point out to countries where there's government-owned media as being not free. And certainly there are issues with government-owning media, but you don't have to own the media to the government to have control over the media. And that comes from journalists who are sycophantically believing whatever government officials tell, particularly intelligence officials, without vetting that information, without challenging them. And as I say, their motive is careerist, because this is the way they will move up in that system. So we need more information like that, and WikiLeaks is providing that, and hopefully it will lead to action by public to put pressure on government to change their behavior. This is the hope.
Grenfell, I'm the national convener of the International Youth and Students for Social Equality, which is the youth wing of the Socialist Equality Party. We're appealing on all students to come to the defence of Julian Assange, because the attacks against him are really the cutting edge of a broader attempt to censor the internet, to silence critical and alternative viewpoints, very much bound up with the escalating drive to war by the United States, which Australia is centrally involved in. So I'd appeal to all students to check out our website, the World Socialist website, wsws.org.
Okay, great. Thanks very much. So can we ask one more question?
Sure.
We wouldn't describe ourselves as socialists, but we're very impressed that it's the socialists who've actually come out and put on the rally. Do you think that, why do you think it's not a more mainstream thing to be supporting Julian, or why do you think the Socialist Party in particular has taken up the cause?
Well, I think one of the points that we've raised is that capitalism is no longer compatible with democracy. I mean, you have a society where the richest three individuals in the United States control more wealth than the poorest half of the population. And it's not all that different here. The richest 1% controls more wealth than 70% of the population. Under those conditions, I mean, all of the major decisions in society about war, the allocation of resources are taken by a tiny corporate and financial elite. And we see, you know, a turn towards authoritarian forms of rule in every country. So we say that the fight for socialism is inseparable from the defence of democratic rights, and that you can't really defend democratic rights without challenging the rule of the financial oligarchy which dominates society.
Okay, cool. What do you say to the young people who are ignorant, like unaware or unmotivated to act on Assange?
Well, they're no different from whether they're young or not. Ignorant and unmotivated people ought to abandon their ignorance. That's number one. That's pretty easy, you know. There's no excuse to be ignorant. This isn't yet a dictatorship. There's plenty of ways of finding out what's going on without reading the Sydney Morning Herald or turning on the television. So ignorance is really is something that no one can justify. Unmotivated? Well, that's really up to oneself, isn't it? How do you feel about the world? Do you want the world to change? Do you want a permanent state of war? Do you want divisive politics that divide countries? All these are unnecessary. If you go along with that, well, then you clearly can't be motivated. But if you don't go along with it, then it's up to you to be motivated. The key here is that it's up to you. You know, we're not in a... This is not some great church where somebody comes down and preaches, this is what you should do. It is always up to you. And young people like yourselves are actually privileged. And you should use that privilege, because perhaps you won't have it all your life. That's very, very important to take action on behalf of people who are not privileged, who are not advantaged, and who are struggling for basic principles such as freedom of speech and justice, social justice. And Julian Assange is one of those. So, in other words, there's plenty of reasons to be motivated.
Okay, what's going on? We've got the Three Musketeers here. We've just finished up the rally here in Martin Place. Went for about an hour and a half, had some big speakers, got some good footage and some interview afterwards. What were the initial reactions, Alex?
Really good, actually. I thought in general, it seems like Carnage House Productions tend to share some of the values of the Socialist Equality Party. Who hosted it. Big shout out to them. We obviously don't share everything, but we've got to give props to them. They're probably campaigning the hardest to get Julian out of here, so they get a big shout out, I would say. But overall, good event.
Ross, any reactions?
Oh, look, I would have liked to have seen, you know, 10,000 people here rather than, what do you reckon, how many people do you reckon we're here?
I reckon 110.
100 to 120 or so. Good.
Including
on them.
One or two CIA operatives.
There are a few deep state undercover workers, I can see.
A few deep state.
Russia conspiracy narrative has been used to both justify only circumstances.
Operatives, but I say, you know, somebody has got to
put this stuff together.
Put it together, and the socialist, what are we called? Socialist Equality Party has done the hard yards. They're obviously trying to get some sort of a political earn out of it, but they were, I thought, fairly even-handed. In that, reality is that Liberal Party and the Labor Party are equally useless in defending the rights of this Australian citizen, and the policy of both the Liberal Party and the Labor Party and the Greens is do we take this with or without lubrication? I mean, it is a...
Won't somebody please think of the children?
complete submissive surrender. It's just lying prostrate before the enemies of this Australian citizen and just taking whatever they dish out. It's disgusting. And if the socialists are prepared to stand up against it, then I will stand with them 7 days out of seven.
We're getting the hammer and sickle out and we'll be there marching with them.
Overthrow the elite. Can we get a like and a subscribe and a comment for Ross Cameron's return to social media?
But if you don't like it, don't be put off by him. He won't be a regular if you're not a fan.
Trump did get a couple of unfair touch-ups. We finished. We came out in support. Time for a beer and a discussion.
Alex. Exciting times. I can't wipe the smile off my face. It's been a great afternoon.
We're going to go home and make our hammer and sickle signs. Seems like the way forward. I reckon we can do our ones outside the ABC if we ever do one.
Yeah, or the
BBC. In Canberra. Do it in Canberra.
Yeah, we'll go down there. We'll do a day trip.
We'll do a day trip. If we organised a rally, would you guys come? Click a comment.
Yes.
Say yes, I would come to the rally if you made one.
Cool. I reckon that'll wrap it.
That'll wrap it?
That'll wrap it.
Any more dribbling?
No dribbling.
No dribbling left. Time for a beer.
Time for a beer.
Bye-bye.